Thank you very much, Dr. Moreo and Dr. Rosati. You helped me. I am very happy with you and your technique and your progress in the neurointerventional procedure. This is very, very, I am very happy. I present two cases, maybe three, I don't know, because I don't remember this talk, but it's a change, a morphological change after long-term radiotherapy. Two patients is treated before, 30 years before, with a cobalt therapy. The first patient is 56-year-old and have a progressive hemiparesia. It's treated cobalt therapy 21 years before. Progressive hemiparesia is you are the chronic evolution of the AVM. It's possible to treat this and improve the patient. This is APV. And where is the nidus? Where is the collateral circulation? What is this? Here you are the origin of nidus is the anterior cerebral artery territory. And this is the collateral circulation of the middle cerebral artery. The deep part is this part. APV. And you have some dilatation here, this and this. In lateral view, it's most difficult to analyze because you are the pericallosa, callosa marginalis. Then you are dilatation of the, I don't know why, maybe feeders, I think it's aneurysm, hemodynamic aneurysm here. This is another big aneurysm, and this is the feeder. And this change, morphological change, is secondary to cobalto or radiotherapy. You are here, hypertrophia of vasa vasorum in this feeder, and its fear is neovascularization. And you analyze this loop is a loop with one aneurysm, ectasia aneurysm in the pedicle. I navigate distal part. I inject the field. This is the field in AP view, lateral view. The aneurysm feeder is here, but this is the distal feeder. Distal of aneurysm, and this is the nidus. Look here, the aneurysm. Now, it's better to know. This is the distal part is closed. I continue to embolize this part and this part. But you embolize here, you don't go in here. You need before catheterization distal part, and then inject in this case, field. This is the compartment of the anterior cerebral artery. Look here, the aneurysm, the distal part, some catheterization. And this part is treated with Onyx. It's possible to combine Onyx and field. The only difference is the opacity of the cast. After third session, you see the aneurysm here, pedicle aneurysm, and you less flow in the AVM. And in this moment, I decide to treat this patient with the middle cerebral artery, and I invited a Dr. Udak to Madrid, come to Madrid. I decide to treat the patient with the middle cerebral artery. This is the lateral middle meningeal artery, sorry. This is the lateral view, this is AP view. But this ectasia, and this is the vein. But in the vein and ectasia going to the middle cerebral artery. I put here the catheter, AP view, And this is the onyx going. And only with this pedicle, I inject this part or AVM. This part is collateral circulation of the AVM induced by radiotherapy. You are the connection with the anterior territory of the posterior. And this is the control in the middle cerebral artery. This is the deep part. And this is the control in the anterior cerebral artery and the anastomosis of posterior collateral circulation, leptomeningeal, posterior, and choroidal cerebral artery. I continue to embolize anew in the anterior callosa marginalis artery, APVU. This is a selective. This is the cast after APVU. And this is the final. This is the final cast of this AVM. And this rest is a remnant. It's possible maybe to treat this part. And now you see better what is this anatomical change. You are here one feeder small, and you are the dilatation. You are dilatation here, you are here. It's possible to know where is the structure or anatomical structure of the AVM. The second case is a young patient treated before 20 years before with cobalt therapy and have come in this hospital with a subarachnoidal hemorrhage. This is AVM, half one aneurysm. Donde está aquí esto? Just a minute. Okay. This aneurysm is bleeding, this aneurysm. And this aneurysm is secondary to induced by cobalt therapy with the PICA. And here, some, maybe another aneurysm. But morphological change after cobalt therapy in this AVM, you are the blush of the nidus is not homogeneous, it's heterogeneous. You are a part of the nidus is calcified, maybe is fibrosis, very complex. In the first time I treated the aneurysm with the glue, this is pedicle aneurysm, and this is distal cerebellar branch, and this is the anastomosis and going to the nidus. This patient have persistence of falcial sinus and don't have the straight sinus. This falcial sinus have some tabiques, como son tabiques? Wall, some wall in the vein, and to close the aneurysm and to treat this, I decide. Well, this is the CT scan. You see the calcification here. Chronic calcification after a chronic AVM and radiotherapy. I decide to treat it. This patient with arterial and venous approach in the same time. You are here, the fibrosis in the sinus. It's not easy to come here. And you are ectasia here on the amponia vena galeno. And you are here, the one vein, second vein, and third vein. And you are the feeder come with the pica and the middle cerebral, ICA here. And the distance of the arterial opacification of the nidus and the venous opacification of the nidus is important. It's very close. It's very, you are much distance, is not possible to treat. This is the venous catheterization in the segment of middle part of the AVM, the catheter is here with the venous approach. This is AP view. And this is the arterial catheterization. You are different in the venous drainage of the venous catheterization and venous here. This is not, problem. This is not problematic. Only you know what is the anatomy, because you need your embol stay in place of the nidus and don't migrate of this branch. And it's possible to sometimes, or in this case, to have the venous dam bivertenic in the venous pouch. It's because the when I inject the onyx here, some part migrate to the vein. This is a lateral view. Some part is migration here. And the microcatheter in the vein is here. And this is the stop with the onyx. It's very comfortable because it's possible to inject the onyx with the venous without the artery. Only use the artery approach to put some onyx here and going in this part. I think it's lucky. And this is first injection. And you are in the venous approach, going to multiple part of the nidus. Some reflux here may stop here. Is this? No. It's a very good embolization. After first embolization, this is the control. And in the second embolization, I'm going to this part. Sorry, to this part. Catheterization, a new catheterization of the vein. AP view, lateral view. Look, the catheter is here. This is the arterial. You are the distance from the nidus. We're going to this part. When you inject the glue here, onyx, sorry, you inject here and you see going to this part. After embolization, the second session, you are this compartment of AVM. AP view. And this is the third session. You are the posterior part, is the same. And embolize this part. The patient rests a minimal part of the minimal portion of the nidus, and very well. And this is another example. It's not with is not treated before with radiotherapy, but have the same progressive hemiparesia with another the first patient. Look, it's complex AVM, it's deep Sylvian AVM and lenticulostriate AVM. You are 1, 2, 3 big pedicles. I think this is a middle cerebral artery, accessory middle cerebral artery. This is lateral view. I treated this patient with arterial and venous approach. In the see here, the middle accessory middle cerebral artery. And this is part, this is injection of the some pedicles. This is the first cast or the first session of embolization. Only one pedicle. This is the second session. And you have the cast. You have the feeding lateral view. And then I'm going to the vein. This is after embolization. And embolize to the vein. And this is the final control with this part. I think this part is possible to treat now with radiosurgery. Thank you for your attention.